of Computer Aided Manufacturing. I am Neha Joshi, Assistant Professor in Mechanical Engineering Department at LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology. Let's start with our 7th chapter, that is Computer Integrated Production Management System. In previous session, we discussed about production planning and control, then objective of production planning and control, function of traditional PPC, and problem associated with the traditional PPC. In today's session, we will cover different topics like material requirement planning, inputs to material requirement planning, outputs of material requirement planning, and manufacturing resource planning. Now, first of all, what is material requirement planning? Material requirement planning, or which is also known as MRP1, is a computerized function or a computational technique which converts the master schedule for the product into a detailed schedule for the procurement of the raw material and vendor manufacturer components. Or we can say MRP is a computer-based production planning and inventory control system. It is a material control system that attempts to keep adequate inventory levels. It is also assured that required materials are available when needed. Okay, so it consists of three primary steps: taking inventory of the materials and components on hand, identifying which additional ones are needed, and then scheduling their productions or purchase. Now, material requirement planning include material plan, inventory, then reporting, purchase orders, and works orders, as you can see here in the diagram. Okay, so material requirement planning is a complicated function. It requires a lot of data compilation and processing. The master scheduling provides the weekly and monthly production plan for a number of products. Each product contains the number of components. The different components are made of different materials. The manufacturing schedule for the different component is different, and so is the material procurement schedule. Therefore, the material requirement planning requires high degree of computation and can be done effectively with the help of computers only. The effective, efficient MRP1 will help greatly in purchasing function and in minimizing the inventory of the material. So this is the MRP1. Okay. Now, what are the objectives of MRP1? First objective is to ensure right quantity of material is available for production at right time to produce right quantity of final product. The second objective is to ensure minimum inventory. And the last objective of MRP1 is to maintain the delivery schedule of the final product. Now, factors to be considered in MRP1, we will discuss all the factors one by one. First factor is dependent and independent demands. Now, what is dependent demands? Dependent demands means the demand for the item A depends upon the demand for the item B. For example, the demand for the raw material depends upon the demand for the particular component, and the demand for the component in turn depends upon the market demand for the product of which component is a part. Therefore, in a dependent demand, it is necessary only to forecast the market demand for the product and establish the delivery schedule for the product. Okay, so based on the delivery schedule for the product, the requirement for the component and raw material can be precisely estimated. Okay, so MRP1 is a very effective tool in estimating required related to dependent demands. Next one is independent demand. Now, what is independent demand? Independent demand means the demand for the item A is independent of the demand for the item B. Now, let's take an example. The demand for the spare parts is independent of the demand for the product. Therefore, in the independent demand, as demand are not interrelated, it is necessary to separately forecast the demands. Now, second factor is lumpy demand. Now, in some cases of the manufacturing, the demand for the raw material or the item will occur at continuous constant rate. In some other cases, the manufacturing, the demand for the raw material or the item will occur in a large increments rather than at a continuous constant rate. The large increment corresponds to the contained batch of final product. Such demand in a large increment is known as lumpy demand. Okay, so MRP1 is the effective tool in planning for the lumpy demand. Now, third factor is ordering and manufacturing lead time. Now, the lead time for an item is the time required to complete an item from the beginning to the end. Now, there are two types of lead time. First one is ordering lead time and second one is manufacturing lead time. Now, what is ordering lead time? An ordering lead time of an item is the time required from the initiation of the purchase requisition to the receipt of the item from vendor. Second one is manufacturing lead time. Now, what is manufacturing lead time? The manufacturing lead time for an item is the time required for the complete manufacturing of the item from start to the finish. A precise estimation of lead time is vital in correct MRP 1. Okay, so last factor is item of common use. In manufacturing, a single raw material may be used to produce more than one type of component. Again, a single component may be used one or more than one final product. Okay, so for example, a same alloy steel rod may be used as a raw material for different components. Similarly, M10 screw may be used on number of products. So MRP1 is used as an effective tool in planning the procurement of such commonly used item. So these are the factors which are to be considered in MRP1. Now we will discuss about the input parameters to MRP1. Now the MRP1 converts the master schedule for the product into detailed schedule for the procurement of the raw material, materials and vendor manufacturer components. The MRP1 program is given three input parameters for performing its functions. As you can see in the diagram, first one is master production schedule, second one is bill of material and third one is inventory record. Now, what is master production schedule? The master production schedule for the product specify how many units of each product are to be delivered and when. Second one is bill of material. The bill of material gives a list of parts that make each product. The bill of material for all products put together give the bill of material file. The BOM file and master production schedule are fed as an input for material requirement planning. And the third input is inventory record. It is important to have the current inventory record in material requirement planning. The inventory record file along with the bill of material file and the master production schedule are fed as an input to the material requirement planning program to get the output of MRP1. Now, what are the outputs of MRP1? Here you can see different outputs of the MRP1. First one is the report of the plant supplied order. Then second one is supplied orders. Then third one is rescheduling notice. Fourth is cancellation notice. And fifth one is inventory status report. Now, what is report of plant supply order? These reports contain the supply orders planned to be released in the future. Second output is supply orders. The supply orders are to be issued by the purchase department. Third one is rescheduling notice. A rescheduling notice indicates the change in due dates of supply order, which is because of change in the master schedule. Fourth output parameter is cancellation notice. Now the cancellation notice informs the cancellation of supply orders because of the changes in the master schedule. And the last output is inventory status report. The inventory status report gives the detailed status of the inventory. So these are the outputs of MRP1. Okay. Now we will discuss advantages of MRP1. First advantage is quicker and accurate planning. As computer is used as tool in the MRP1, it helps in quicker and accurate material requirement planning. Second advantage is issue of in time and correct supply orders. As supply orders are automatically generated as the output of MRP1, thus can be issued in time. In addition, the supply orders are free of errors. Third advantage is quick response to change in master schedule. Now, any change in master schedule can be quickly incorporated in MRP1. And the fourth advantage is reduction in inventory. From the master scheduling stage of the stages to the issue of supply order, the time required is very less. Therefore, the inventory can be reduced by 30 to 50%. Now, next advantage is reduction in manpower. Due to the use of computer in material requirement planning, there is a reduction in manpower. Next advantage is improved customer service. Now, MRP1 greatly helps in minimizing the delay in the delivery of the product to the customer. Hence, it improves the customer service. Next and last advantage is greater productivity. Okay. So, MRP improved the productivity by 5 to 30%. Now, we will discuss about the manufacturing resource planning. Now, what is manufacturing resource planning? Manufacturing resource planning can be defined as the computer-based production information system that integrates and coordinates all the major functions of the business to produce the right product at the right time. Or we can say manufacturing resource planning is defined as the method for the effective planning of all resources of a manufacturing company. Ideally, it addresses operational planning in unit, financial planning, and has simulation capability to answer what-if question and extension of closed-loop MRP. In early days, the meaning of the manufacturing resource planning was limited to the planning of the machinery, material, and manpower of the company for the manufacturing activity. However, with the use of computer, the scope of manufacturing resource planning has broadened tremendously. Now, MRP2 integrates and coordinates the different activities like business planning, production planning, capacity planning, master production scheduling, resource requirement planning, material requirement planning, capacity requirement planning, and production activity control, as you can see here. Okay, so this is what about the material requirement planning, which is known as MRP1, and manufacturing resource planning, MRP2. Thank you for watching this video.